Dr. Jason Saunders here with HBOT USA. We're going to talk one more time about how to calculate the dosage of oxygen for a treatment that we're doing with hyperbaric oxygen. So we've already covered in previous videos the idea that a PO2, the pressure of the oxygen that you're being exposed to, is ultimately the dosage of the oxygen. What we're going to talk about here is how time also plays a role in that same process. It's not just what the pressure is or how much oxygen, it's also how much time the person's being exposed to. And in some cases, time could become very valuable, that you may increase time dramatically in order to make up for where pressure is unable to happen based on equipment challenges or whatever the case might be. So here we have a really simple example that we'll go through, but basically what we're saying is the amount of oxygen with the amount of pressure and the length of time, the amount of minutes, OPM, is really the full calculation of oxygen dosage. We're going to call that units of dosage of oxygen. So here we have just a really simple one. 1.3 times 100% oxygen would have a PO2, so an oxygen dosage of 1.3. 1.3 atmospheres at 94%, let's say you're using an oxygen concentrator, so, and you have a really good seal on the mask that you're using, we could say that that's about 94%. So 1.3 times 94 will give you a PO2 of 1.22. And then we have another example, 1.3 times 84%. Let's say you're having an oxygen concentrator and the mask you're using is leaking, it doesn't have a good seal, so you're getting some ambient air mixed with whatever oxygen you're being brought in. You can come up with around 84% oxygen uptake. And so in that case, the PO2 will come down to 1.09. And so just very simply, you could see how you could manipulate those variables to change ultimately the dosage, the full dosage of oxygen. So if we have 1.3, if we have a PO2 of 1.3 and we're in there for 60 minutes, you'll have a unit dosage of about 78. If you're at 94%, 1.22, you're going to have a dosage of about 73 units. And if you have 1.3 and 84, so you have a PO2 of 1.09, you're going to have a full dosage at 60 minutes of about 65. So you can see that the unit dosage of measurement is definitely very different at the end of a similar amount of time. If you change those numbers, and in our example here, it doesn't really take much, but here we would be at about 64 minutes, and here it's about 72 minutes. So if we changed the time and we just added 4 minutes here, we added about 12 minutes here, we would get the same unit of dosage. And so the goal here is just to say, listen, there are a lot of ways to manipulate pressure, manipulate oxygen concentrations, and manipulate time to make sure that if we said a certain protocol for a patient, that we could create that protocol based on whatever equipment that we have access to, as long as we can manipulate those variables to get a similar full dosage of oxygen. I hope that helps. If you like these videos, absolutely please subscribe. Also, in the comments on any of our videos, please add some comments of other information, other videos, things, questions on your mind, things that you would want us to post about. Our whole purpose here is to educate people on hyperbaric oxygen, and so I'm happy to answer any questions that you guys might have. Talk to you soon.